Take it from Ezekiel Elliott. The Dallas Cowboys saved their season with a stunning upset of the defending champion and reeling Philadelphia Eagles on Sunday night at the Link. Elliott's big game was complemented by a clutch defensive performance by the Cowboys, but it's so much more about the bigger picture. Cowboys owner Jerry Jones told me about the pregame talk he had with his beleaguered coach Jason Garrett when he asked Garrett point blank, "Is this enough pressure for you?" Garrett responded that with the flood of criticism directed at him, he's even more resolved to get it done. And then he went out and coached like it. He coached like a man with some urgency when he went for it on 4th and 2, called a fake punt, converted it, and it led to a field goal that gave the Cowboys some early points. But of course, it's Dallas, it's drama. And Jones also told me that yes, he thinks Oklahoma coach Lincoln Riley is a prime candidate to make the leap from college football to the NFL. In other words, stay tuned.
The Los Angeles Rams lost their first game of the season last week, and the question was in Week 10, how will they respond? Well, with a 36-31 victory over the Seattle Seahawks, their division rivals, they showed that, number one, they're going to be just fine, and number two, they can actually count on their defense to help them win some games. At 9-1, it's clear that the Rams are going to compete for that number one seed in the NFC with the 8-1 New Orleans Saints. But because the Saints beat the Rams last week, they have that tiebreaker. Still, LA can clinch the NFC West as soon as next week. They need a victory Monday night, and they need the Packers to beat the Seahawks on Thursday. About that Monday night game, though, it's in Mexico City, and it's against the 9-1 Kansas City Chiefs in what really is just an awesome must-watch matchup. It should be so much fun, and it really could be a Super Bowl preview.
The Tennessee Titans delivered an authoritative win over the New England Patriots, and in so doing, they gave the league a blueprint on what you have to do to neutralize that threat that Tom Brady brings, and that is to bring a lot of pressure. This should be a bit of a concern for the Patriots because for the third time this year, when they went against a fierce pass rush, they lost. First it was the Jacksonville Jaguars, before they fell apart. Then it was the Detroit Lions, led by another Belichick disciple, Matt Patricia. And then this week against the Tennessee Titans. Next week they have the Jets, but the week after that, they've got another vaunted defense, and that's in the Minnesota Vikings. So they've got to make some adjustments, figure out how to do a better job of keeping Tom Brady upright. For the Titans, this was a big win because they're trying to make up ground on the division leader Houston Texans, who've won 6 straight and are on a bye this week. But this was a big encouragement for their players because they realized that they can play against a quality opponent from start to finish. Now they're above the 500 mark, they want to continue to climb in the standings.